Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. So in today's video, what we're going to be doing is checking out an application, a calendar application at that, called Sunsama. Now I know a couple of the people will be mentioning in the Facebook group about it, and I thought it would be a convenient point just to grab a few moments to take a look at it. What I'll do in the description below is include all of the lovely timestamps so you guys can go away. If you want to skip ahead to the certain features that Sunsama have, then you can do so. Now, the real premise of this application, so this application has been around since 2014. It previously was more of a meeting resource, like an agenda tool, than it was a calendar application. But now it's sort of evolved into a team calendar application that tries to rival the likes of the recent Sunrise application. You can even see by the logo that they've sort of taken that very similar inspiration in their recent rebrand. So here I'm signed in with my Google login, which didn't take long. And as you can see, this is the sort of home panel you get met with. We'll start by talking about the view options because I think that's quite important. Sunsama, you don't really just get the calendar view. You get calendars or task view, or even calendar and tasks, or task and calendar view. So you have a multitude of options. So this is the calendar view that we're on, and you also get a time frame option. So you can either choose between 1 day, 3 day view, which is actually quite a nice view because it's a bit more detailed in terms of seeing your next 3 days ahead. Weekdays, and that's you can use all the shortcuts on side like five. So for example, if I click 5 now, I'll go over to weekday view, week view, so that's full 7 day view from Monday, and month view. And month view is pictured out like that. So you can see, you can toggle through them obviously, so that was February, and you can go through it like that. So it's quite a neat way to visualize all of your tasks. So for example, let's say I just want to go on weekday view just in this case. I actually haven't got anything on this calendar for this week. Let's move over to task views because task views, I guess, another important thing. Essentially, tasks are associated by date. So for example, if I wanted to add a task, all I have to do is hover over on the day view or the day area. And as you can see, what opens up is very similar to Asana boards in some extent. You can see that I've got an icon that automatically detects that I'm going to be doing the task. There is a one called Move to Backlog, which we'll explain in a bit. And you can also add it to an additional channel as well. So that's a sort of addition to it. But I'll explain as I type away a task. So let's say I just need to take out the rubbish, something nice and simple. And as you can see, once I've got off it, you can see that I can click into the item. And the great thing with this setup, the actual tasks, is you actually have a clickable task off. So if you did want to complete it, then you can do so. Up here, you can actually add it to a channel. You can create a channel, so that can be based around teams. So you can have a marketing channel, sales channel, etc. You can take notes down here, comments, and even attach a file to the certain item. So you can also add a due date as well. So you can, of course, have a start date, which is today, but you can also add a due date. So let's say it's the end of the week. All the activity log appears down here too. You've also got the ability to change, and you can even just unassign it or assign it to another person. Up here on the right, you can make it private or actually disable notifications. You can export tasks or delete task and copy the link as well. So if you want to send it to a teammate, then you can do so there. And you just close that window. It's quite a nice little panel, I have to admit. It's well designed. Let me just demonstrate what it looks like when you've got this one here. So you can create a channel, you can give it a purpose. You can add the Slack integration as well, which actually does save a bit of time, or the GitHub repo integration, which will allow you to link all of that good stuff up, and you can give it a color too. So I'm just going to give it, for the purposes of this one, marketing, and I'm going to create it. And you can see here I can edit it or hide it and add any more additional ones here. But in this case, as you can see, I've created marketing, so I've just given that a bit of an assignment, which is quite nice. So if I hit that backlog one, it moves to the backlog, which makes it unavailable. essentially, I think that means that it's going to go in this side panel here, where you can essentially bring it back for later. So if I wanted to drag it back onto a certain date, I could do just from there. So it's almost like a pausing spot. Personally, not used a backlog before, so it's quite new to me, but you can add additional tasks to that backlog, making it a lot easier. Now, essentially, this is a Kanban view, so you can drag it across states, and you can even check the item off once you've done it. I'm not sure why you would do take out the rubbish for marketing, but it's an item I could put in there. So you can see up here that because I've got it in that sort of three windows, it brings up a hover view, which is quite nice. Just a small addition. The design itself is actually very, very attractive and something that was quite notable when I started using it to just look at. So there is a tertiary view and a quarterly view, no, fourth view, but I'll just go into third view. You can see actually the tasks and the items and the actual history of the day. So for example, if I had a certain item, I can actually see, okay, I completed that task at 3:26 p.m. And then I can click in and actually create a specific event here. So let me just go through what it is like creating an event. So maybe I want to say conference. I can add it to the marketing channel, or I could create one from there. I could give it a specific time, or I could just say it's all day, or you know, even a time zone, which is quite nice. Whether it's repeatable, you know, all the regular stuff that you do on a channel, add a location, even add a room as well. So if your team have set rooms, like five rooms, you can name it number five. You can add a description. That's not necessarily the agenda. I'll move on to that in a sec. Invitees via email, and the actual organizer calendar too. So you can actually plot that there. Now there is settings. You can add a reminder, a 5 minute to 2 hour reminder, whatever, anything in between, which is great. And any blocking too. So you can appear busy on that one. It depends on your calendar default settings. Now, notes down at the bottom, you can start creating an agenda, which is quite nice. So maybe for the conference, I'm going to say kick off the keynote, take notes during the third guest speaker. And you can see by here that I can add a timing to it. So let's say I want to add it 10 minutes or 20 minutes here. And I can even assign it to a certain person. In this case, it's me. And you can actually see that. Now, you're probably wondering, what is a playbook? And playbooks are really simple. All you have to do is create a playbook. You can even browse the playbooks they've got there. And you can even clear the agenda from here. But I'll explain that in a second. But it's just something extremely useful when it comes to moving about the day. Now, if I go to... that's very, very odd. It's disappeared. That was probably because I didn't save it. If I save it, that's actually a feature that maybe they should take note of. But maybe that was just me being a bit silly there. So once you've saved it, obviously you have the details there. And you can even add, once it's up, it's a good excuse for me to go back in it. Once it's up, you can add attending, not attending, cancel event. You can even add the notes from there. You can add actionable items from there and comments too. And you can even share it, change the privacy and go into display mode, which is quite cool. So for example, let's say you're in a meeting mode, you can actually see the agenda view as you go through it. So you can pin that up on the board, which is quite nice, I think. And once you start it off, there's a timer and it will move on to the focuses. So if I had lots of different ones, then I could. And I could even look at event logistics just by snapping away a few there. So, it, you know, you could even have the Wi-Fi password or anything on there and even add comments with your team. So I guess that's quite a nice experience. I accidentally did that, of course, but it's something that I think will be very attractive. So you can see, let me just go back to that calendar task view, that you can start seeing a outline of the day just by there. So that's a very nice new addition. You've also got tasks and calendar view. So you can see the tasks as a main setup versus actually in the layout, and you can plot any calendar items here. Now, it's really simple to find all of the calendars that you have and even activate them just by tapping them, which is quite nice. Which is very easy to do. And if you wanted to, you could hover over one, change the edits settings on this one, whether it's primary access and all of the color options and things like that. So I guess to some extent, this is very similar to Sunrise, minus the integrations with the ability to do task and Kanbanning to some extent. So this is quite a nice view. You've got up here just a little zap, which gives you all of the new features. But apart from that, this is very much available for those who want to use it individually or team members. It really is up to you, but I guess it's sort of like Get Plan combined with the likes of Sunrise. So guys, I hope that you found this review just generally useful. Remember, if you want to share this with some of your teammates, you can do. Just share the YouTube link. If you're not subscribed yet and you're someone that is into this sort of software, it'd be great to have you in the community. You can join this Facebook group as well. And also, you can join me on Skillshare. So anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this one. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive. And I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.